Return to the graveyard. We went there earlier. If you have reasonable short-term memory, you might remember it.
We need to get out of this graveyard. The glass demon's key might help.
Dan! Buoyancy is not your strong point!
That's how you do it.
This gate don't have no key. Weird.
So
Nice move, David Jones.
This path leads to Undertakers. An old acquaintance of yours, eh, Dad?
Why?
Can I help you, my musty friend?
Oh.
Dead bodies everywhere, all over every blooming where. Look, there's a walking corpse. And one over there, and oops. Yeah, I smell another.
There's Death.
Greetings, stranger. I'm Death. It is I who eased the passage of lost souls on their final journey. The hours are hell, but I wanted a job working with people. But hold. Have we not met before? Sir Daniel Fortescue! I've done you once already. I never forget a corpse. It's that pesky Zarok. I'm up to my eye sockets in the ex-deceased. Business hasn't been this brisk since the great massacre of Melomede. I may have to take on an intern. Help you fight Zarok? Of course. If only to get some rest. I'd be off on holiday topping up my tan if it wasn't for that evil old madman. But there is a way to stop him. You'll need the Anubis Stone. It was used by Zarok 100 years ago to create an undead army. The very army that you fought on the day of your, arrow-based mishap. After that most bloody of battles, the Galamir people acquired the stone. To prevent its power being used again for evil, they broke it into four and gave each piece to a trusted member of the realm. You'll need to find all four pieces to use the stone's power. Then you can summon up an army that can compete with Zarok's elite guard, the terrifying Fazghouls. They sound like a trapeze act, but trust me, they're a lot less fun.
Where the hell
well,
are they?
I've seen and heard many things on my deathly duties. I could write a book, you know. Of course.
Sure you can.
Touch it. All I want these days is romantic fiction and epic poems. Anyway, one piece was buried with the great Moloch chief. His tomb is in this very cemetery. The mayor of Sleeping Village inherited a piece from his predecessor and knows its current whereabouts. There's a rumor that the Witch of Pumpkin Gorge has a piece in her possession, although she may have put that about herself to drum up some tourist fortune-telling trade. Ah, yes. And the fourth and final piece is in possession of the deceased King of Galamir. Assuming he is still deceased, you never know these days, do you? I mean, look at you. But if he is, it'll be locked in his castle vault. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You're very welcome. Now go and stop Zarok before he drives me to an early grave.
You're dead. You're already dead. So... so there's that.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. It's mortifying, it really is. There's no end in sight.
I just want to saw like another path, but I guess I was wrong.
By the sandals of the wandering hippie, the famous Moloch Chief's memorial. A piece of the Anubis stone.
Well, that's
power
a piece
and
of
worth
it.
Is unimaginable. I know a barber can get this one.
That was obnoxious.
Excellent work, my brother.
Stupid
Let me ruffle your
Oh, never mind.
But we have escaped. Galomir Plains lies beyond that gate.
The Hall of Heroes.
Sorry, what can I tell you? Your name's not on the list.
I'm just messing. In you go.
Welcome, O undernourished one, to the Hall of Heroes, where the bravest warriors from...
He has the shield. This one is a big sword, okay. He's the axe. This is the bow and arrow guy.
At your mercy.
And he's a
running
lion.
Around in your bones, Fortescue. You are just so nouveau dead. Huh? I, Raven Hooves, last of the Centaur Princes, have not the earth in 1,000 years galloped. Last time out, I won on the flat by 7 lengths. Carrying 9 stone 11. Crazy. Yourself a favor, do, Fortescue. Take my long bow. It is the weapon of noblemen. My breeding you don't quite have, Mr. Johnny Die Lately. But you do your best, I sure. Ciao, Bell.
I'll just save the game.